Today in this video we are going to see about the insects which consist of 33 orders, out of which we are going to discuss about 3 orders. Already we have discussed about Lepidoptera and Coleoptera. Coleoptera is the special type of insect which has the 4 wings are modified into chitinous structure called elytra that is not used for flying but for giving support while sitting and for changing direction while flying, that is Coleoptera. And Lepidoptera are the scaly wings, that is butterfly, are all coming under Lepidoptera. Those things we have already seen. In this video we are going to see about Diptera and then Hymenoptera and then Orthoptera. So these 3 orders we are going to see. Generally in insects we classify the insects into 2 divisions. One is called pterygota and another is called aterygota. Pterygota means the insect which do have wings, and by using the wings, by the thermodynamics action, that flies, that is called pterygota. And aterygota means aptergota. Aterygota means the insects do not have wings and they do not fly, that is called aterygota. So the animal kingdom, that is invertebrates, these do not have any backbone as like vertebrates. So they have only exoskeleton, that is hard outer body covering, that is called exoskeleton. So the classification is animal kingdom, that is subkingdom, that is invertebrates, and then it is classified into pterygota. Insects are classified into pterygota and aterygota, and then phylum arthropoda. Arthropoda means that is exopoda or jointed legs. Usually insects have 6 legs, that's why it is called exopoda, and the legs are having jointed legs, that's why it is called arthropoda. Class insecta. Insecta means the thing which the animals which do have the exoskeleton, dorsoventrally compressed, bilateral symmetry, sexes are separate in some cases, and maybe parthogenesis in some cases, that is with regard to the sexes usually are separate, the reproduction is by metamorphosis and sometimes incomplete metamorphosis. So these are all the character feature of insects, and that is called insecta. Order Diptera. Diptera means, di means 2, tera means wings. Usually generally they have 4 wings, 2 forewings and 2 hind wings. In the case of Diptera, only 2 wings are present. The hind wings is somewhat not well developed, it will be there, but it is known as halters. A small rudimentary structure like that will be, it will have. So the predominant wing is only 2 wings. So by flapping the wings, by the thermodynamics action, it will fly. That is, only 2 wings they have, unless like other insects. The other insects have 4 wings. So that is the speciality of Diptera. The example is mosquito, wasp. These are all the examples. Mosquito, wasp, these are all examples for the Diptera. They only have 2 wings. So as regards the insect, the head will be head, thorax and abdomen. 6 legs are there, and then the mouth parts is distinct, or a special type of mouth part in case of this mosquito. And then wasp also, and then the housefly also is included in this. Wasp, housefly, and the mosquitoes. In mosquitoes, there are various type of mosquitoes are there. They are Culex mosquito, Anopheles mosquito, and then Aedes mosquito. So many types are there. So according to the nature and the district mark in the mosquito. So as regards mouth parts, they have piercing mouth parts. As like the injection, it will bore the insect and then it will suck the insects. So it is biting and chewing type. In the case of mosquito, it bites and takes away the blood. As like syringe, the labium, the it will inject into the, actually it will not get into the vein, but it will get into the capillaries, because the capillaries are throughout the body. Somehow it will be sticking, it will be making a sting on the dermal region, and it will suck the blood from the capillaries. So that is this, the labium is modified into piercing type, and then the antenna is there, that is called pilos antenna. It will be like a broomstick. So that is the special character feature of the mosquito, that is like a broomstick, pilos antenna, and then maxillary pulp and mandibles are also there. These are the labium is modified into a piercing type. These are the special type of the mouth parts of the mosquito. And then the housefly, it is not piercing type, but it is sucking type. The mouth parts is sucking type. And then the fresh fly, so many flies also, there are different fruit flies, so many flies are there. That also included under this diptera, because only they have two wings. As regards the Aedes mosquito, black and white strips are seen. That is the speciality of the Aedes mosquito. So the Aedes mosquito is responsible for the spread of dengue fever. And then mosquito, there are various type of mosquitoes are there. Anopheles mosquito, Anopheles mosquito, it acts as a host. And when it injects the, when it takes the blood from the host, it will inject the Plasmodium vivax, that is the malaria causing organisms. Actually, the malaria causing organism is Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium malaria, and Plasmodium falciparum. These three things, one will cause 24 hours fever, another will be causing 48 hours, and another is called 72 hours. So that Plasmodium will be injected by the proboscis, which is a syringe like apparatus that will inject the Plasmodium. That is the so the human being is acting as a host, and this also acting as a host. This is acting as a vector. The mosquito is acting as a vector. So the Aedes mosquito will produce dengue fever, and the Culex and Anopheles mosquito will produce the malaria fever. And with regard to the life cycle is complete metamorphosis, that is called holometabolus. That is the entire thing is four stages are there. That is, the egg stage is there. From the egg, the larva will be emerging, and from the larva, the pupal stage. From the pupal, the adult stage will be emerging. So the four stages are there. That's why it is called complete metamorphosis. And with regard to the larva, about 100 to 200 eggs will be laying by the adult, and it will lay the eggs in the water and are in moist areas. So the moisture is required, or water is required for breathing of the larva. So usually it will be in inverted position. The tail portion will be on the surface of the water, because it has a siphon like apparatus for breathing. Through that siphon, the air is sucked inside and it respires. So the larva, that's why to control the larva, usually they used to spray kerosene or some malathion emulsion concentration. That will block the respiratory apparatus, that is siphon apparatus, because it is the floats on the water surface. The kerosene will be floating on the water surface and it clogs the proboscis, the respiratory organs. And then with regard to the pupa, will not take any food during the development, and during this pupa it will develop, the structural arrangements will be developed and it will be emerging as adult. Usually this mosquito will be feed on dead organic matter, and some of the insects or some of the mosquitoes are active during night, and some of the mosquitoes are active during daytime. So the dengue fever, the malarial fever are active during night times. And with regard to the house fly is having sucking type mouth parts. Various type of mouth fly are there, that is house fly, that is fresh fly, fruit fly, so many flies are there. So these are all the with regard to the diptera, and with as regards and even trypanosomiasis are also caused by the mosquitoes. So it spread the diseases. So that too during this rainy time, we should be very careful with the water stagnation should not be in the containers. Particularly in Hindus, some religious functions are they are doing in they make in a vessel, they will be pouring water, and in the water they will be having this mango leaves, and coconut will be placed on the top. It will be after doing puja, it has to be kept for 48 days like that, and it is really detrimental to the inmates of the house, because the insects will be, the mosquito will enter into the vessel and it lay eggs, it becomes larva, and then it becomes the adult. So it will contaminate the entire area of the house. So they aids the dengue fever, and then the malaria fever are caused because of the water stagnation. In the name of religion, this should be avoided. That is one thing. And next, with regard to the order Hymenoptera, that is Hymenop means membranous. The honeybees are having chewing and lapping type. Chewing, that is it takes honey from the flowers, and lapping type, and it has two pairs of wings, and mouth parts is distinct in the case of the honeybee. That is, usually we used to tell that labrum is the upper lip as like us, and labium is the lower lip, and instead of teeth it has mandibles, and the lower lip will be having labial palps and Galea lesenia, and apart from that the maxillary pulp will be there, that is for the taking the food inside, that is called maxillary pulp. So these are all modified structure in the case of honeybee. So the glossae, that is the important it is available in the mentum, submentum, prementum, and mentum. It is available in the mentum, and it is a piercing type. A special type of a pointed organ will be there, that is called glossae. That will get into the flower and takes away the honey from the flowers, and it is also helping for the pollination. So this is the cardo, stripes and other things will be there. Mandible are there, Lesenia, Galea, and mentum. This is labrum. Labrum means upper lip. This is lower lip.
the lower lip is modified into blouse.
And so this is with regard to the mouth parts of the
honeybee.
And as regards mouth honeybee, these are all called, otherwise called social insects. They have three type of, to have a community life, they have worker, drone and the queen bee. Queen bee is the, it lays eggs, and then the drone will be the, it is a male, and worker will be doing, that is sterile, and pathogenetically it develops, and it the main importance of the worker is to collect honey and other thing. So the for the purpose of reproduction, the queen bee and drones are important. So with regard to the sex determination of honeybee, the female will be having diploid chromosome, that is 32 chromosomes, and then the male will be having 16 chromosomes. So this is called haploid chromosome. 16 chromosome is haploid, and this is diploid chromosome. And this diploid chromosome is reduced into, that is by the meiosis process, it is called, or is called reduction division. By the reduction division, the diploid chromosome is reduced to or divided into haploid, that is called meiosis division, and it will be 16 and 16. So by the process of mitosis, it is male, it is developed into a male. Then in the case of the male drone, 16 chromosomes will be there, and by the process of mitosis, it will be again divided to 16 16. So 16 is the, it will maintain 16, and the 16 chromosome plus the 16 chromosome developed from the divided from the female, 16 plus 62, 32 chromosome will be formed as queen bee. So this is with regard to the sex determination of honeybee. That also we have to understand. As regards sex determination of house bee, the female will lay the eggs, that is queen bee, that only have the power to reproduce. Like that, the drone is applied, and that is 16 number of chromosomes. So this is with regard to the sex determination. And another thing, with regard to the economic importance, the honey bee, it gives honey, it produces honey, and then it pollinates, it is also helping for the pollination of flowers, and it is busy because of busiest nature of honeybee, it can collect honey, and honeycomb is formed, in that honey is stored. So it is so busy, and that is endangered. Some species are endangered. Then we have to see about from the honeybee, honey is taken, and wax is taken. So these are all the byproducts from the honey. Wax is also produced, soap is also produced from that, and then balm is produced, candles is also produced from the honey, the byproducts of the honeycomb. So these are all with regard to the economic importance of the honeybee. And the next important topic we are going to see is the another insect is called Orthoptera. That is, ortho means straight, and the ptera means wings. So by distinguishing the wings, or by identifying the wings only, we are classifying the order. That we have to understand. Ptera means wing. Before that, ortho, neuro, iso, so many pteras will be there. So by having the wings structure, we identify the, we order the insects. So here, with regard to the Orthoptera, ortho means straight, ptera means wing. here in the grasshopper, locust are the example for this Orthoptera. This is very important economic importance, because as regards the locust, it destroys the field, it enters devast the field, it takes away the complete leaf and it chew the leaf, and the chlorophyll, complete chlorophyll is taken away by the this grasshopper, this locust. And that we are going to see, it has, as insect have the head, the thorax and then abdomen structures. The legs are, three legs will be there, and the legs are long legs for hopping. For hopping, the legs, the hind legs is so lengthy. And then with regard to the wings are so straight, that is Orthoptera, and so one third of the wing is extending beyond the body. So suppose totally, suppose if five centimeter, the body is particularly the abdomen is 5 centimeter, it is extending beyond the 5 centimeter, means it will be around 6.5 or 7 centimeter. The wings structure will be 7 centimeters. So one third of the wing will be extending beyond the abdomen. So that is the speciality of the this Orthoptera. And then the hind wings will be having it will be producing some sort of sound that is the apparatus be found in the hind wing. And the head is not incapable of rotating, that is called hypognathus. The head is not cannot be rotated, that's why it's called hypognathus, that is the head is incapable of rotation. And tubercle and the prosternum, that is also another important feature. And this is mandibulate means the mandible is so hard, that's why it is mandibulate. And greater wings, that is a speciality, and the mandibulate is a speciality. Legs is adapted for jumping, hopping, that's why the legs are very lengthy, particularly the hind legs are very lengthy. And in these two types of even the locust are also included in the Orthoptera. What is the difference between grasshopper and Orthoptera? Grasshopper is the solitary innocuous. Solitary innocuous means it will be alone, it is not having gregarious habit. You cannot see at a place, you cannot see more than one or two like that. It is not having gregarious habit. So, and innocuous means the harm is not that much. When compared to the locust, it is not doing that much. Both are appearance is similar. This will be somewhat grey in color, and this is a small in locust is be small in color, and it will be flying to the greater distance from Africa, from Afghanistan to Pakistan, Pakistan to Rajasthan, it will enter like that. So it has the capacity of flying to the greatest distance. The locust is having the flying capacity to the greater distance. And moreover, the locust will be doing lot of harms. It suck all the chlorophyll, and the devastation is caused in the field by the field of wheat. Entire devastation is caused. That's why what they are doing, they will be even spraying with the help of plane. They will be spraying to control the locust. So such a powerful and such a pest is locust. So we can see swarming and voracious eater. Swarming means we can see only gregarious habits. Lot of multiples, bundles of locust will be at a places. In at a place, it will be all will be coming to the field, and it will devast the field, and it will take all the chlorophyll. That is the nature of the locust and voracious. And when grasshopper is introduced with serotonin, that will become the locust. So serotonin is the main hormonal structure that convert the grasshopper into locust. These are all with regard to the Schizostoserca, that is Grigeria. This is called grasshopper. That is the genus and species name. Schizostoserca, that is genus, and this is Grigeria species. This is as per the binomial nomenclature of Linnaeus. How the identification is done? That is by the giving two names to all organisms, whether it is respective of whether it is a plant or animal. That is called binomial nomenclature. Genus may be similar and species will be different. All similar characters will be placed under genus and the special character will be placed under species. And the five before that, family, that is order, class and phylum, like that. So phylum, class, order, family, genus, species. So the genus and species are here. This is with regard to the grasshopper flying only by night. During night time it will be flying, and the phyliform antenna is phyliform apparatus, and this is also the morphosis. Complete metamorphosis we can see in this graph, grasshopper. So this is with regard to the Orthoptera. So we have seen three important orders. One is called the Diptera. That is the speciality in that only two wings are seen, unlike other insects which have four wings. Then the hind wings also small rudimentary like structure will be found, but it is not predominant. That's why it is not taken into account, but it is called halters. While flying, it will be expanding, but it will be for halting the insect, that is the mosquito or housefly or wasp. This is with regard to the Diptera. Hymenoptera. Hymen means a membranous. Then hymen means, ptera means flying, like that. Ortho means straight, ptera means wing. So we have seen three orders. With this we complete this three orders of insects, and furthermore orders we will see in the next video. With this we conclude this video.